If you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you, so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place.
Hey, I'm Andy. If you don't know me, it's probably because I'm not famous. But I did start a men's grooming company called Harry's. The idea for Harry's came out of a frustrating experience I had buying razor blades. Most brands were overpriced, overdesigned, and out of touch. At Harry's, our approach is simple. Here's our secret. We make sharp, durable blades and sell them at honest prices for as low as $2 each. We care about quality so much that we do some crazy things, like buy a world-class German blade factory. Obsessing over every detail means we're confident in offering a 100% quality guarantee. Millions of guys have already made the switch to Harry's, so thank you if you're one of them. And if you're not, we hope you give us a try with this special offer. Get a Harry starter set with a 5-blade razor, weighted handle, shave gel, and a travel cover. All for just $3 plus free shipping. Just go to harrys.com and enter 5000 at checkout. That's harrys.com, code 5000. Enjoy.
Good afternoon. Here is the Africa Business News. Half of 1,000 public projects being implemented in Kenya have stalled and will require a staggering 1 trillion shillings to complete. The International Monetary Fund has disclosed, raising concerns about the country's planning and public spending decisions. The huge number of stalled projects, which comes with delayed payments of contractors, is a major contributor to the cash crunch in the private sector, and that has precipitated job losses and reduced cash in people's pockets, with latest Central Bank of Kenya data showing that cash circulating outside banks dropped to 176.9 billion shillings in September, the lowest since 2015. The IMF said in a fiscal transparency evaluation update on Kenya released on Wednesday that the number of stalled projects is increasing and is currently estimated as approximately 500 because of non-payment of contractors, insufficient allocation of funds to projects, and litigation cases in courts. Expenditure estimated at 1 trillion shillings is required to finalize this project. It further says the rapid increase in public investment since 2010 occurred without enough screening for project viability and readiness before they entered the budget. The Bretton Woods Institution noted that lack of effective gatekeeping has allowed many new projects to enter the budget pipeline, creating challenges in the financing of ongoing projects. Many of the public projects lack a cost-benefit analysis as well as standardized appraisal and selection plans, effectively failing to match expenditure to available financial resources and producing white elephant projects. The disclosure follows a meeting between the IMF and top officials from the National Treasury, the Central Bank of Kenya, the Kenya Revenue Authority, the Kenya National Audit Office, the Controller of Budgets and other government agencies, parastatals and regulators that handle or oversee public projects in preparing their reports. Revenue performance has failed to hit targets at the same time, meaning that the government has led to borrow heavily to finance this project. Servicing the debts and financing a large recurrent expenditure bill takes up the lion's share of state revenue, leaving the Treasury unable to pay development expenditure bills and thus stalling projects. Thank you very much for listening.